our first speaker in this afternoon is Professor Miri Scharf. Miri is the head of the Department of Counseling and Human Development at the University of Haifa, and is also involved in individual psychotherapy at the psychological services of the university's Bremen Student Counseling Center. Her research focuses on close relationships throughout the life cycle and their implications on individuals' normative and divine developmental trajectories. Over the years, Professor Scharf has been involved in intervention projects with parents and children that translate the knowledge and insights gained from the theoretical and empirical research into more effective and evidence-based practice. Her talk is on resolution of difficult experiences and future parenting. Please welcome Professor Scharf.
So I present the works of Pnina Eisenberg Borenstein and Tracheli Macro Rosenberg, and I supervise them, and I will try to present these two projects. You heard about attachment, and you will hear about attachment, so I'll do it quickly. Attachment relationships influence individuals' regulation of emotion and the use of intra and interpersonal resources when coping with stressful situations. Adverse experiences can tax individual resources, but can also promote hardiness and influence how people handle subsequent negative experiences. When faced with a stressful situation, securely attached individuals are likely to openly express distress and mobilize problem-solving strategies. Based on their past experiences with close others, securely attached individuals may turn to close others for support to overcome stressful situations. Individual with high levels, generally I'm using the adult attachment interview, but this presentation are based on self-report questionnaire. Individual with high level attachment avoidance are more likely to use deactivating strategies when coping with stress-related situation, restrict accessibility to and suppress expressivity of their vulnerability, and be less likely to turn to others for support in coping with difficulties. Individual with high level of attachment anxiety are more likely when faced with stress-related situation to use hyperactivating strategies, express intensification and exaggeration of threats in order to draw and maintain their close other attention when distressed. Stressful experiences might threaten individual sense of meaning, mastery, and self-esteem, and increase the risk of difficulties in their daily functioning, including parenting. It is a lack of resolution of experiences, rather than the adversities themselves, that it is associated with subsequent problems. Some individuals, however, are able to resolve adverse experiences after a period of time. Generally, it's not in this minute, and the resolution is reflected in the individual's reorientation to the present and future, and achievement of balanced view of the impact of the experiences on themselves. I will present two studies. With generally, I examine also father, don't worry, but in this presentation, I'm focusing on mother, and the experience of stillbirth and the experience of labor, a normative labor, if I can use this word, and the beginning of parenting. I will start with the stillbirth. Stillbirth, the birth of a fetus that has died in the womb or during delivery after week 20 of pregnancies, arouses similar, and according to some researchers, identical or even more severe reaction to those aroused in other cases of bereavement. 25% of women who had stillbirth develop depression, anxiety, or post-traumatic stress disorder during subsequent pregnancy or after a birth of a healthy child. Prenatal loss has also been linked to marital relationships difficulties, including divorce and feeling of failure as mother, wife, or a father as provider and protector. Grieving and resolution of the experience of stillbirth can be complicated. Parental grief following stillbirth may not be culturally acceptable. Usually there are no funerals or public rituals of mourning for the prenatalness. Parents often feel that they cannot openly express their grief because it is not socially recognized. Duca used the term disenfranchised grief to describe a loss that is unrecognized by society. Stillbirths can also engender personal growth. Following a stillbirth, some parents were found to feel more caring and compassionate and less likely to take anything for granted. Some couples felt a greater closeness and a special bond in response to the loss of the loss they experienced. The quality of the marital relationships and social support was found to predict the differing severity of couple grief after a perinatal loss. In this study, we employed quantitative and qualitative methods in order to examine these issues. 30 pregnant women over 20 gestation weeks, aged 25 to 35, without children, who had experienced stillbirth after at least 20 weeks of pregnancy within 3 to 12 months prior to enrollment in the study. This is the research group. The control group, 30 pregnant women in the first pregnancy, a paired sample, with the same background variable without a loss of a fetus. There were no differences between the group in education level. This is highly educated women, lengths of marriage and duration of pregnancy. There was a difference in the ages, 31 in the research group and 88.6 in the control group, probably because the women in the research group had a previous pregnancy. This is the measure we used. Experiences in close relationships questionnaire, the Berkeley-Leiden adult attachment questionnaire to measure unresolved loss. It was developed by Mary Main and Terry Kess and Vine Ashendon in order to find questionnaires to examine unresolved loss or trauma. We used also personal assessment of intimacy in the relationships and also a questionnaire regarding future parenthood, perceived ability to take care of children with the measure of roles, I told you about it, parental attitudes toward child rearing, a maternal separation anxiety test, and short health anxiety inventory. In addition, 10 of the women who experienced stillbirths were interviewed using semi-structured clinical interview to enable a deeper examination of their coping. We asked them also to draw a bird nest, and but I will not tell about it now. Result in discussion, women who experienced stillbirth had higher levels of attachment anxiety and attachment avoidance and higher level of unresolved loss than the control group. No differences in couple intimacy and perception regarding future parenthood. It is possible that this characteristic existed before the stillbirth experience, though it is probable that this traumatic event, at least temporarily, harmed the women's psychosocial characteristic. The higher level of attachment avoidance and anxiety can reflect the need for distancing while still needing close support, and worries that close support would not be adequately and consistently provided. It is likely that higher level of unresolved loss result from the difficult and twist and traumatic loss they had experienced. Attachment avoidance moderated the relation between stillbirth and perceived parental practices. No association between avoidance and warmth towards the imagined child among women in the research group. However, the association among the control group was negative. no association between avoidance and strictness among women in the research group. The association among the control group was positive. So the control group behaved normally, but the stillbirth group behaved differently than should be expected. No association between attachment anxiety and future anxiety regarding the child health among women in the research group. The association among the control group was positive. However, attachment anxiety related positively to negative perception of the child in women from the research group, whereas the association among the control group was not significant. Surprisingly, this result suggests that even though the experience of loss is a traumatic event, in some cases it may buffer women from the negative implication of their perception of the imagined relationship with their child, and it does not harm the couple intimacy. The stillbirth experience might soften the distancing tendencies of women with higher level of avoidance and reduce the level of anxiety regarding the child health of women with high levels of attachment anxiety. Especially among individuals with high level of avoidance, traumatic experience may instigate less controlled display of emotion and behaviors and may actually help them in acting contrary to their tendency to keep distant and aloof in close relationships. Note, however, that women reported on their imagined parenting, it's not actual parenting, and the result should be examined in actual parenting. I will give you an example from the qualitative analysis. Ayala described their difficulties related to unrecognized loss. The environment does not understand anything about you, anything you are going through. They want to help and do not have the tools, and some people just do not have tact. I had a girlfriend whose pregnancy was a month longer than mine, who told me that the first time we talked, at least you didn't carry the 8th and the 9th months. It's like, listen, I would be very happy to carry those months, really happy. I had friends at work who completely ignored the loss, even when they saw me, as if it did not happen. It is mostly men. They didn't know what to do with it and just passed by. Despite the tendency of women who had experienced stillbirth to distance themselves from the spouses, express anxiety regarding the next pregnancy, and perceive themselves as having damaged maternal identity due to the loss, they also saw their distancing from the spouses as part of natural part of processing and resolving the loss. They describe the loss as an event that strengthens them and made them better women and mother. As far as I was concerned, it was a sign of life in general and not necessarily something that has to do with the stillbirth. That's not the point. I have no such concern. I will be a mother. I will adopt if I need to. I do not deal with it now. I just want to be a better person. That's what I got from it. What kind of mother will I be? That's also a fear. I don't know. I can't say that I will be a good mother. I hope not to be impatient mother. I work on myself. I am impatient despite my profession. She is from the clinical professional. And so of course my job is in life will be to develop patience with my child. That's it. It's the only thought that worries me. That I not find myself like all the parents yelling at their children, even though I know it's not education. Another mother told, I believe that the moment I become a mother, I will be a different mother, better than I would have been if I had given birth on time. The narrative demonstrates growth stemming from the experience and an optimistic yet balanced and realistic view by the women of themselves and their future parenting. The second study is about the childbirth experience. The experience of labor and delivery has a special and moving place in the lives of many parents. According to a meta-analysis, probably you heard about it in the first day that I unfortunately missed, The prevalence of postpartum PTSD ranges between, I hope the frequencies are similar to what you present, between 3.1% among community samples and 15.7% among risk sample. Further, between 20% and 48% of women perceive childbirth as traumatic and report several PTSD symptoms. Several matters contribute to the distressful experience. Birth intervention, pain, negative subjective birth experience, dissatisfaction with the care received during the delivery and feeling they were treated uncaringly, lack of support, feeling powerless and out of control, and flooding of emotions. Unlike other traumatic events, birth is normative and prevalent experience, and talking about the birth experience is widespread and culturally acceptable. The opportunity to retell the birth story might facilitate a coherent perception and narrative of it. An unresolved traumatic childbirth experience can interfere with the development of the bond with the baby. The aim of the second study was to examine longitudinally the association between attachment security and the experience of support during childbirth and the resolution of the labor experience and the quality of and the interaction with the baby 3 months later. The mother-baby interaction was examined when the baby was 3 months old using observation of the mother emotional availability, the ability of both parties to respond to feeling, desire, motivation, and aims in a mutually adapted manner. We have 33 mothers and their babies. The mean age of mother was 28. 97 of them had an academic education. 70.6 had participant in a preparatory course for the birth with their partner. 72% received epidural during delivery, and 18% were supported by a doula during birth. 30 SARs, so you can see that at least in this population it is prevalent. 33 reported special difficulties during labor, such as intense pain, fetal distress, or vacuum birth. The first assessment was during the third trimester of pregnancy, and the second assessment when the babies were 3 to 3.5 months old. In time one, we used the experience in close relationships questionnaire, the Berkeley Lydent adult attachment questionnaire to examine unresolved loss. They enacted support, and in time two, we interviewed all women regarding the mother perception and the resolution of the childbirth and how she feels about her child. We used the emotional availability scales. At first, mother were asked to play a structured game with the baby, selecting from 3 available toys, an activity mat, a rattle, and a mirror. In the second part of the observation, the mother were asked to play freely and choose what to do with her baby. What is generally done when you do the emotional availability observation? Questionnaire, we used also, again, the questionnaire regarding support during childbirth, so they report about it retrospectively. And we ask about the childbirth traumatic event scale, and to identify women suffering from trauma as a result of the childbirth experience. No association between high level of anxiety attachment and support during childbirth. Mothers characterized by high level of anxiety or avoidant attachment tended to have more traumatic perception of the childbirth experience. So insecurity is related to a traumatic perception of the childbirth experience. In the qualitative analysis, more than half of the mother describes the childbirth experience as very difficult. Lack of control during the birth, fear of their own and their baby death, and the negative feeling, anger, frustration, despair regarding the birth and the attitude of the mental medical team. Among mothers characterized by high level of avoidant attachment, a positive association between support during birth and the maternal feeling and sensitive responding towards the baby. So it is surprisingly, these women exhibited a non-customary behavior during labor. This might reflect changes they underwent during their pregnancy that enabled them to turn to others and effectively use this help. Possibly the result of having supporting close others who might have helped them revise their perception regarding the trustfulness of others, what Rawls proposed. The stress they experienced during labor might also have disrupted their automatic response and facilitate modification to their regular ways of coping. Their enhanced ability to turn to others and to use their support might also have been used when raising your baby. It doesn't matter whether it's due to the capacity they develop or I will tell you about the narrative it will demonstrate. The secure group, I called them, I have learned about myself and grew stronger from the experience. Mother in this group reflectively evaluated their experiences during childbirth. They were able to recognize the best and the worst parts of the experience, even when the experience was difficult and did not match their expectation. Despite the difficult memories of the experience, Hannah was able to focus on the positive parts of her labor, including her self-strength in coping with the childbirth. I really felt like the queen of the world. I felt like the queen of the world in the whole process, as if from the moment the labor pains began until the baby was on me, I really felt like I was a queen, that I could stand it and could do it. Here I am doing it. It's a bit painful, uncomfortable. Actually, it does not hurt a little. It hurts a lot. It's uncomfortable and it's difficult. But here I am doing it, and here another labor pain. Today, in retrospect, I can say I'm going to get the biggest prize I can ask for. This is very important era of my life. It's kind of an event, I can say a formative event in my life, just like that, really a formative event. As I said already, I learned a lot about myself. I really became stronger from this event. It put me in a place where I also softened very much from this place from this event. When referring to her child, she said, I believe that my child came to soften me a little, and that's okay. It's not terrible if I didn't do something to the end or told him he's like, I don't have to be by the book. From my side, that's I am here gives him some kind of feeling that the mother is right here, and you will always have somewhere to go back to. You will always have a house. If you choose it, mother will always be there for you. In contrast to these women, the second group was characterized by ambivalent perception of pregnancy, and I call it if it is good and if it is bad, there is no way back. Yuval described difficulties in acceptance of the pregnancies, fear of loss of autonomy in her life, and fear that the baby being born would harm her relationship with her partner. As if once you have this, the pregnancy, there is no way back. Then it's such feeling of, really? Really, it happens? That's, no, there is no other way, no way back. So as from there, it was only to understand that there are going to be changes and to accept that and that I will not be with, as if I will not be with my husband alone, and it is difficult. Until now, I could be free and do what I want. It will be together, but only together of a different kind. And that I would have to be entirely committed to the little creature. It's hard, as if to understand that from the point that I am the center of my world, or my couple relationship is the center of the world, my child is my center right now. It's the difficulty. Yuval described the caregiving of her baby as instrumental and expressed feeling of alienation and distance. It's factual from the start. You are a girl, I will be the mother, there is a need to change the diapers, to feed you, to put on you a new diaper, to help you with blushes to change your clothes. At first, she, the baby, really was a piece of nothing. She just was there. She did what I wanted. I wanted to change her clothes, I changed her clothes. She wanted to sleep, she slept. She wanted to eat, she ate, as if it was very, very, very laconic. Not thrilling and not exciting. Similarly, another woman said about her baby, until now he was a lump, such a potato that eats and sleeps, food the hyper. I will move to the third group, the avoidant group. Mother in this group describes the experience of childbirth in a restricted way, with limited description and short answers. In addition, they lacked emotional expression and were emotionally disconnected from the process they experienced. Throughout my pregnancy, I lived my life exactly the same. In retrospect, I do not remember myself pregnant, as if I had passed it quickly. I did not feel, I had no side effects during pregnancy, I did not feel a change or something, but really a completely normal life. The entire period of pregnancy, I cannot tell you that I had an amazing change. I cannot tell you that I had any change in my body, except that my belly was out. I did not feel it, I did not understand. I think that even today, I did not understand the meaning of that I was pregnant. Nothing, nothing, nothing. I lived life, my life is exactly the same. Even today, I cannot tell you 1,000,000%, her baby is mine. I know he's mine, but I do not feel. As if sometimes I say, voila, I have a child. As if I hold myself and I say, voila, I am a mother. It is not real. Centrally, not after 3 months, at least not for me. Our house, you know, every moment someone comes in, goes out. We grow up together in the neighborhood here. We were here and my partner, I just made lunch and a good friend of ours comes in. My partner came out from the computer and asked, where is the child? And she laughed. I tell him, I don't know. I didn't notice, but maybe one of them took him out for a walk. After half an hour, they came back. Do you understand? Like we live life, he lives it with us. No, I do not feel like suddenly I cannot do things because, so as if there is no feeling of fundamental life change. I will summarize. The experience of stillbirth and even labor of healthy child can be traumatic and stressful for the mother. These experiences may act as trigger, turning individual vulnerabilities into actual difficulties and instilling stressful reaction in the mother. A healthy resolution process is an individual successful effort to accept the fact that there has been a change in her external world and rearrange his inner world accordingly. It is a disordered mourning process might be expressed in particularly intensive and long-lasting emotional reaction. The healthy resolution is reflecting the reorientation to the present and the future and the balanced view of the impact of the loss on oneself. The studies highlight the risk and the protective factors in the normative life, stressful life situation of the transition to parenthood. Attachment security can buffer the adverse application. In contrast, high level of attachment anxiety and attachment avoidance and prior unresolved loss make individuals more vulnerable. The socio-cultural context also play an important role and can decrease or increase the chances that stillbirth and labor will turn into disenfranchised grief. And the strong value of the family together with almost universal desire to marry and have children in Israel make these children related experiences especially susceptible. In the case of stillbirth, the burial in mass graves without notifying the burial site make it complicated more. I will finish and I will give you time to move to the second.